Operational report. Submarines detected. Convoy still loading at Chittagong. Oh, still that supply problem. Repairs complete. Contact report, contact report, contact report. No attacks, though. Kill credit. Recon over Kochi. Recon Langkawi, Chichijima. Contact report. No attacks, no attacks. Here's the Sokuten. Contact report. More recon. Tanjung Pinang recon. Fukuyama recon. Kotao. Repairs complete. Expansions. Oh, I guess Iwo, we can stop the fortifications now. We have plenty of supplies, but don't burn them for nothing. Replacements taken. Repairs complete. Reinforcements, Alameda, Oak Harbor. These are the fighters transferring over to Alor Star. Over in Hong Kong, no submarines are ready, still in refit. Over in Shanghai, we have no submarines needing refit, but look, three submarines are damaged. So let's get these guys repaired. Whoa! Wow, Palau. Yeah, that was the one that got hit so bad, hellaciously. We should be giving her a commander a medal for getting it back safely. Okay, so we're gonna Pito will repair and Finback. We'll put him into Piercy. Just get him out. Looking good. Hold on. There's Hake. Where's Hake? Hake. Ah, okay. Well, we can repair it in one day. That's good. The other submarines, we have three submarines, one for each patrol zone. The base force is here, moving up to Fuchao. We'll arrive next turn. Fuchao's been doing pretty well for itself. Two artillery regiments, anti-aircraft artillery regiments have been shooting down at least one plane per turn. So maybe I should just let him bomb. Let him bomb. If we're moving over from Shanghai, I'm going to order the vanguards to... Okay, they've already shut down. They're good. They're resting. Zero fatigue. Ready to move over. We have a squadron of... Oh, where'd they go? P-40 kilos. We had moved them over. They're ready to go across if needed. On the peninsula... We have recon. Holy crap! 9 out of 10 Kochi is unoccupied! Holy crap! That's huge! We could take a base on this side of the Pacific. I knew there were no base fortresses there because the coastal defense fortresses, they're like castles. They don't pop up overnight and they wouldn't come up. But I didn't think the AI would leave it totally undefended with no units over here. So I knew of the location of a castle here, castle guns here, fortress guns here, fortress guns here. I don't think that's taking advantage of the game simply because you would know that. In real life, you would even know that. You'd have an idea before the war, and the war's only been going on for, what, a year and a half? For them to build a castle in a year and a half? Impossible. So, looks like Kochi is unoccupied. Also, we've got Fukuyama is also unoccupied. So another prime possibility for parachute assault. He's got two ships here, but Takamatsu is occupied. Okay, he's got at least one unit there, some kind of defense unit, but we still also have a sub chaser here, and Matsuam we know is empty. Tokiyama is empty. We're now conducting reconnaissance on Matsui. I'm going to double check. We're going to bomb Fukuyama. Last night, the bombers were scheduled for Takamatsu, but did not fly. Instead, I'm going to allocate them to Fukuyama to try to take out those two ships in port. I don't even know what they are. I know this is a sub chaser. I don't know what that is. So we're flying Fukuyama, Recon, Matsui, Recon, and Okayama. Okayama, also Recon. We don't know what's here. This is changes the whole complexion of the game. We may not have to fight our way ashore. As I demonstrated on the other islands out here, always better just to blast the hell out of them and just walk in. We don't need to conduct an amphibious landing where we can lose men and ships. So I'm going to be rushing my paratroops up here. I've got three parachute formations so far. I have the Indian. Where are they, guys? Where are you? Don't be shy. Well, where are my Indian paratroops? Okay. Nonetheless, I have a fifth. Where'd they go? The 50th Indian Parachute Brigade. I have the Chindits. Two units of Chindits. I've got to get those guys over here as soon as possible. If we can take this by parachute assault, lay the groundwork, make it an easy, unopposed landing. I can take this one by parachute assault. I can even use my transport submarines to put raiders on here. If it truly is undefended, then I can... Well, twice. We've flown this mission. We've seen it twice. I'll fly it again, but if it's undefended, I can use the Marine raiders to grab the base the day before and then land my troops that night or the next day unopposed, so we don't lose them trying to land over a beach. Landing over a friendly port is hell of a lot better. So if I take this by with Marine raiders, then I can parachute assault here, 1, 2, 3, or maybe even here, or 3, or maybe Matsui 3. But I've got lots of transport. I can put them on the ground. Problem is, if I put them on the ground, Tokuyama is too far away. I don't know if I can support it. Also, I don't know if I'll get over to Fukuyama before the enemy comes in to crush us. It's an injury. I could sacrifice the parachute brigade just to grab a foothold here, tie up the enemy as we work our way up Takamatsu. It's a thought. It's food for thought. Okay, so we're going to be trying to bomb out the ships at Fukuyama this turn. We've captured Kotao. We're going to try to reduce that fortress this turn. The rest of the army here is marching to the east. Yep. We're going to catch the rest of the column here. There are 6 units. Let's try to wipe them out in the field, with the possibility of an easy assault landing on Shikoku. We're now moving with the purpose. Get the paratroops over to North Korea, Fusan probably, or Keijo. We're probably Fusan as quickly as possible. The ground elements are still moving over to Shanghai. Not as great an urgency. We still have to get ships up here. We need to establish the beachhead at Shikoku before thinking about coming to retrieve units at Shanghai. But we're trying to get the parachute units over as quickly as possible. I'm pulling out the air transports, gathering them at Chungking. Chungking is moving them forward to Keijo, and Keijo has stored some up at Changchun. We've overstacked the base a little bit, but it's just a holding pattern right now, so we don't have a lot more base forces coming forward. But now it's time, which the invasion could go off even earlier. We're running everything up the railway on the coastal road to Langson and beyond to Hangzhou. Bangkok We have, oh, we have a couple more. Okay. Two more anti-aircraft artillery regiments. Let's get them down to, well, let's try to get them down to Saigon. Oh, for the love of God. Okay, we're going to be stupid. Another West African. Okay, he's going to be obstinate. Oh, another light anti-aircraft. Yeah, this one will go. And the Burmese auxiliary anti-aircraft. Right. Anyone else? No, we seem to be doing okay here. The observer, okay. Moomin, we have the British brigade still moving south and the Chinese moving north at Prome. We have, oh, okay, more units arriving. Get into, oops, what am I doing? I just canceled the movement. Ah! What an ass I am, huh? I pressed the wrong freaking button! God, what an idiot I am. So I canceled all their progress down the road, whatever, just to get these pieces of crap off the railroad. Oh. Stupidity. Okay, we pulled out some of the... I'm keeping the Liberators back here. They have such phenomenal range. I could send them, but I'm going to keep them here for now. I'll let the C-47s need to transship to Chongqing before they make the final hop over. Okay, now we have the Chindits here are getting on the train to get out. I still need a few Chindit squads in order to invade Langkawi. So what I'm doing is I'm taking the patrol squadron here, the Catalinas. I'm using them. I'm going to move a couple of Chindit squads over to Kota Baru to stash them so that once the bulk of the Chindit brigade will leave, and then I can use the five or six squads, that's all I need to capture the base and pull out. Now I've got to be careful. Here's the railway. I don't know which route the AI is going to take. If he takes the train up this way and then this way and then through Kota Baru, he's going to, once he enters the same hex, they'll rejoin, and I don't want that to happen. But if he goes up the other way along a lower star, then I can, then I'll move the, either way, I'll move them one side. If the squadron's sitting here and I see him moving up this way, I'll move them over to the other side of the railroad track so that the rest of the Chindit brigade can travel. This one, I've got to get the Chindits out of Victoria Point into Chumpon and on the railroad. We want to get them. They're going to withdraw in 600 days, 500 days. That's still plenty of time to conduct parachute assault. Our units have moved over to Alora Star, and so all the fighters are here, but the AI still managed to damage it by 3% before it left. So I'm going to put a couple of units back here, maybe a headquarters, maybe a couple of anti-aircraft artillery units. I just need them there for one turn to clean up the mess that the AI managed to hit before the troops managed to leave. Piss me off. More units have arrived. Oh, a couple of the base forces that transferred out of Chittagong have arrived. Now we're going to march them down to Shuibo and hopefully across. Chittagong. Oh, look how dry that place is. Oh, God, 6,000. Well, okay, we're going to keep taking out some of the transports. Managed to get a few supplies. No more coming from Calcutta. Ceylon is quiet. Bombay is quiet. Nothing coming in, nothing coming out. This tanker convoy is unloading about 7,200 more fuel than heading out. Here comes another tanker convoy, another one coming out of Abadan. Otherwise, no other reinforcements. No additional reinforcements. Cape Town. Submarine check. No submarines damaged, but Capelin got hit right on the doorstep. Yeah, coming in. Bam! Well, she got a couple of torpedoes off herself. Good for her. Good for her. Any other submarines damaged? We're looking in good shape here. Checking for endurance. Truant needs to be recalled. I think this will be her last patrol. We'll send her off to plug the gauntlet. Capelin Sturgeon needs to be recalled. And Seahorse. Where are you, Seahorse? Which one of you down here is Seahorse? There's so damn many submarines, huh? There we go. Seahorse. Torpedo check. Lots of torpedo engagements, but only O-23. Looks like she's fired everything to the front. One forward firing torpedo. I'll call that one offensive torpedo. Remaining O-23. Okay, O-23. Yeah, recall to Singapore. Well done, good patrol. Timor Sea is quiet, but I've got fighters at Darwin. I sat them down. The Lightnings and the Warhawks have been sitting here resting, waiting for recovery. I'm going to upgrade the 38 Foxes, and I'm going to try to send them over to Asia to fight. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pull these guys back. We don't want to be burning supplies up at Darwin, so I'm flying them back to, where is that? Townsville. Sure. Townsville, we'll drop in and I'm going to, let's go. 38 Echo, done. There are still other squadrons needing 38 Foxes. So that's not a real loss here. Okay, we'll drop them in. We're using these just to ferry them across. Remember, the 38 Echoes have the incredible 50-mile ferry range. We also have the P-40 Kilos. These guys, what happened to them? 27. Oh, we've been using them to train pilots. That's what we've been doing. We're going to use drop tanks. Yeah, we're going to pull them back as well. Let's get back to Townsville. You know what? I'm not going to worry too much about the rest. Let's go. Let's use the ferry. Not the Lightnings. 38 Echoes. I'm also, well, let's upgrade to something else. Let's upgrade to 38 Echoes and then something useless. What's useless? We'll use November 1s. Nobody's using them right now. Okay, done. We'll upgrade. Now we can go back to upgrading to 4 Echoes instead. That way we don't need to risk damaging 25. Okay, we'll then recover and then we will send these off to Singapore. We'll leave the Aussies, two Aussie squadrons of Kitty Hawks I'm hoping they should be able to hold the line here. If not, we can bring more. At Townsville, we have, here's the 38 Echoes, okay. Let's upgrade them to something useless. What's useless? We can borrow the 40 Bravos. Okay, upgrade. All we're doing is burning supply here. Yeah, it burns a lot of supply. Who saw that? How much? Was it a couple of thousand supply? I don't know. I can't keep track. But we have plenty more supply than we have plane. I'd rather save planes and pilots. Now that we burned them, okay, now we're going to upgrade to the 38 Echo. There were several engagements. Look at them. Look at that bastard. He's coming right in here. Was it here or here? Could have been here. I don't, or here. I can't remember. But they're coming in. Shallow waters. Look at him. He's inside the reef. The bastard. Look at him inside the reef here. Well, we had a couple of encounters. We refueled. We rearmed. Keep trying. Keep trying. Two more submarines detected in the north. Here comes my battleship group coming across. Okay, at reference point 2, we're going to refuel before heading off onwards. The convoy. Oh, God. Really? You piss at little. Oh, well, that's okay. That's okay. We will transfer it. This is almost done, this convoy. Oh, what I know what we'll do. We'll do the usual. We'll sail it away, order it to sail, and then have the rest of the, once it finishes unloading, the rest of the convoy, we'll join it. That's what I'll do. That's what I'll do. At Guadalcanal, the replenishment convoy. Oh, look how big this damn thing is. Look at them. And we can even dock here. Holy cow. Go ahead, unload. Wow. And the enemy, I think the submarines are moving to the northeast. So he's making transit through here. Northeast, probably going home to refuel. And rearm. Convoys passing each other. One returning to Guam and one heading into Townsville. As predicted, the transports safely evade the submarine. He's still moving eastward. What the hell? Is he moving back and forth here? Possibly. Possibly. And we've detected the submarine off Guadalcanal. Doing not much. That's fine. Let him do not much away from us. We're still unloading at Baker Island, trying to unload a couple of small transports. Just get them over the 20,000 mark. We're over the 20,000 mark. No rush for these guys. Palmyra is clear. We have a couple of fast-moving transports. 17, my special forces, moving to Christchurch. The Cape Nettic is still trying to load, about halfway now, so one more turn to load. She'll be gone for Pearl Harbor. Pearl Harbor. Tankers have arrived, unloading. Make sure we dock and unload and return the same way. With a million points of fuel already on Guam, I don't see how we're ever going to use all that myself. So we'll just load up Pearl. Pearl is with a million points of fuel as well, but Pearl is much easier to fill with fuel because it's a big, much bigger dock. We have destroyers waiting here. Let's see what ships are coming out. We have a cruiser. Oh, nine more days. Okay. Well, we'll wait for the transport. We can wait for a couple of the assault transports, and then we'll escort them up to Guam. On the west coast, we have another reinforcement at Alameda. Okay. Great Republic! Thank you for the button. No other ships are arriving. We have... Oh, here. We have a bunch of ships that have returned. That tanker... Okay, replenish, disband. Yes, thank you for ignoring my orders. Replenish, disband, and one tanker ready to go. Go for it. We have an assault transport, troop transport, the APA. We're going to load. There's only 100 squads left over. Are there even 100 squads here? 10 squads. 10 squads. 100 men. Waste a whole transport on it, huh? Yeah, whatever. Whatever. That's okay. So we finally have, after all those ships, we finally loaded the whole thing, taking it to Guam. Sailing outward. All right, we'll send these into so a lot of these have to refit, and then we'll start. It looks like another tanker convoy headed out. At Vancouver, a whole bunch of ships came out of resupply or refit. We're sending one transport down to sending it alone. Just why not? Nobody else moves at that speed. We're also sending... Well, hell. You know, we'll send you some company. We'll send Largs Bay with it. Even though there's a big disparity in speed, to hell with it. I can't... Not worth the clicks to set up another task force. Here's another task force. We have transports. Also with my special forces, Sea Fox. The Sea Fox, these 17s are going to be heading for for New Zealand, while the troop transports will just bring it to Pearl Harbor. On the islands, we have just more transports unloading, trying to get the AOs to finish off unloading to see if we can't upgrade them. The carriers are outside. Ooh, we'll replenish at sea. That's fine. Yep, suck out all that fuel, guys. Use it all up. The more we... Well, now looking at Guam, the repairs, the fleet, the floating repair dock. Oh, it's one day away. One day. Let's get it fixed. Let's find out one way or the other if this works or not. The battleships are returning. Oops. Where'd they go? Here they are. Returning to Pearl Harbor to fix their the two torpedo hits they took up at Hajima. Here's the invasion force. They're going to take another day and then another day before they actually get to Hajima. So, I got time. We're now loading the fast transports with the naval support squads. The, what do you call those things? Port detachments, right? Right, port service detachments. We're making sure we don't want to burn out the engines, so we're making sure they go out at cruise speed. We're going to rejoin over on Hajima and then see what's needed on Chichijima. The amphibious ships probably don't need them, just like we showed on Iwo Jima. We don't need the amphibious ships. We'll go in, capture the base, and then use the service detachments to unload the follow-on elements. The battleships are going to still give another bombardment. Keep going. Every time we hit it, last turn was wasted because we didn't hit any of the ground forces. Where was that here? There we are. There's no supply there. So what's the... Why would you say there's a supply hit? There's nothing there. The airbase. Okay, we hit the airbase, but unless we can hit the troops on the island, we're not suppressing anything. And now we're... Notice all the damage to the base and port. Let's hope that we get the same result as we got on Iwo Jima. We just capture it and it's 100% undamaged. I'm pretty sure that's a bug, but hey, game lets me do it. What am I supposed to do? Not bombard? Iwo Jima, the CBs have been going crazy. We're going to expand it next turn. I have been bringing the transports up from Townsville. We staged forward to Hollandia, and we will stage forward to Guam, then to Iwo, and then across to Korea. We should be there in time to get the parachutists in. Now to decide where to put them. We have one parachute capable, one air transportable unit. That's the Chinese army here, once I buy them out. We don't have enough points right now, but once I do buy them out, these guys will be the second wave, but I have three air parachutists. I have more parachutist units down here, but they don't do us very much good when they can't exactly attack. From Chichijima, the closest is 14. That's not close. The range of the transports is only 12 and 13, I believe. Normal range is 10. I'm not sure if the AI will. I'm not sure if we can conduct a parachute assault at extended range. I don't think so, but I'm not positive. That's the C-47s. These guys are even shorter range, C-33s. Yeah, so these guys, it's an impossibility to conduct parachute assault from the Bonin Islands. We might be able to hit one of these. No. We could hit the islands, maybe, or up here, Aogashima, but what's the point of that? Growler encounters a sub-chaser. No fire is exchanged. Air raid, Fukuyama. The liberators attack. Hit the port, but not the ships. Air raid, Fukuyama. No defenders. We hit a sub-chaser. Fukuyama bombed again. Sub-chaser. Was it the same one? I can't remember. Bombed again. Missed. Well, hitting the port. Kind of wasted effort. Chichijima. Wasted effort. Just hitting an airbase already crushed. Fighter sweep. Hiroshima. 18 lightnings are in. 4 NATE fighters destroyed. Fighter sweep. Kagoshima. 18 fighters are in. 1 Oscar destroyed. The enemy replies by attacking Suitao. Oh, now you... Yeah. Oh, so we put fighters on your... Yeah, typical AI stunt, right? Only attack the ones that cannot defend. Okay. More of this silliness. 1 squad disabled. 4 enemy damaged. Hiroshima under attack. Five lightnings, fighter sweep. Fighter sweep Kagoshima, no enemy activity. Bombing practice Akiab. It's good to note that a Vengeance has attacked a Type A midget submarine. This is on top of Pearl Harbor. So even though it didn't hit it, it's nice to see that it tried to attack it, and that's, well, all full points for trying. Wish we had hit it. Bombing practice Akiab. Ah, bombing practice Langkawi. 2 more support squads destroyed and 1 more engineer disabled. Bombed again, another engineer squad disabled. More practice bombing Akiab. Not getting many hits. Practice bombing Nakhon Ratchasima. Air raid, 14th Army moving through Touraine is bombed, 2 headquarters squads disabled. Kotao, deliberate attack, 33-1 odds. Enemies, heavy casualties, minor casualties to the Chinese.